Everyone, in this video we're going to be simplifying a trigonometric expression. Now trigonometric expressions are fun because you use a lot of identities. This is kind of like a fairly simple one. I just wanted to give you, you know, a problem like this where you can apply basic identities. Okay, great. So now we have 1 over 1 plus tangent x and sine x over cosine x plus sine x, and then we're going to simplify this expression. Simplifying basically means at the end you may find a numerical answer like 1, negative 1, 2, or a trigonometric function, possibly something like sine x by itself, or sine x times cosine x, or 1 over tangent x, or something like that. But something that is simpler than this. So I'll be presenting two methods, and the first one, I haven't tried it before. I'm just going to explore and we'll see how it goes. So you're going to see naturally how I approach a problem like this. So we're going to make a common denominator, obviously. First approach, we multiply this by that and this by 1 plus tangent x. Okay? So I'm going to multiply those, and of course on top as well. So the top is going to be cosine x plus sine x times 1 plus tangent x. And at the bottom, we're going to have 1 plus tangent x multiplied by cosine x plus sine x. Doesn't matter which order you write them in, as long as you write them correctly. Now, one thing we can do is, you know, distribute everything and then take a look at the expression. We're hoping that this is going to be a nice expression at the end. So let's see. If I multiply these, cosine x plus sine x plus sine x plus sine x tangent x. Don't simplify it yet. Like, I don't want to replace tangent with, you know, something like sine over cosine yet. I just want to distribute everything. Cosine x plus sine x plus tangent x cosine x plus tangent x sine x. Awesome. Great. Now, one thing that will help us here is, first of all, I notice, are they the same, numerator and the denominator? No, they're not the same. They're different. So what can we do? We can actually now write the tangent as sine over cosine and then multiply the top and the bottom by cosine. So for simplicity's sake, let's go ahead and use the following convention. Replace cosine x with c and sine x with s. And now we're going to back substitute at the end, okay? So it's going to be, and of course, I'm going to replace this with s over c, which is sine over cosine. So we're going to get c plus s, it's 2s actually, plus s times s over c divided by c plus s plus, this is s over c times c, and this is s over c times s. Okay, now let's go ahead and simplify this a little bit more. C plus 2s plus s squared over c divided by c plus s plus, those c's cancel out here, and then that ends up with c, so that becomes 2c. It's like 2c or not 2c. And then plus s squared over c. That's interesting. We got the same thing. Wow, really, I wasn't expecting this. But anyways, this is cool. And now, since these are equal, and the answer is 1. Cool. Great. Simple, right? Sort of. Now, this may not seem like the best method, but it turned out to be fine, I think. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the second method. Let's see how that works. So I have 1 over 1 plus tangent x plus sine x over cosine x plus sine x. Great. So for my second method, I'm not going to make a common denominator. Instead, I'm going to replace tangent x with sine over cosine right away. Let's do it. Again, you can use the CS convention if you want. It's totally up to you. I'm not going to use it. It's not too bad. So now we get this. Now, I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom here by cosine x, because that's going to eliminate the fraction, right? It's equivalent to making a common denominator and then flipping and multiplying, pretty much same thing, but it seems a little easier to me. So when I distribute, the cosines cancel out, and I end up with sine x here. And then the second piece fits in nicely, kind of like a puzzle, right? And notice that these two fractions, after the simplification, of course, we replace. So in other words, the idea is turning everything into sine and cosine, pretty much. That works 99.9% of the time, maybe 100%. And then notice that they have the same denominator, so I can just add them, the numerators. And then, of course, the numerator and the denominator are the same. Therefore, this is equal to 1. Of course, provided that cosine x plus sine x does not equal 0. And also provided that cosine x does not equal 0, because then tangent will be undefined, like pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So we kind of have to avoid those cases. But in identity problems, they are usually excluded. You don't have to worry much about it. And this brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. I'll see you next time with another video. Until then, be safe, take care, and bye-bye.